Hey everyone, take a seat, get comfy. I'm about to tell you all a story. Six months ago, I landed in LaGuardia Airport in Long Island with no idea what to expect out of this next semester. I was a very anxious person. I moved into my first apartment in this area that I didn't know too well. It was loud and clanky, and the buildings were short and dirty, with dim lighting and uneven flooring and spiraling staircases. I lived above a restaurant and across the street from a 24-hour deli, and I couldn't ever fall asleep. Even throughout the middle of the night, it was loud, but it also felt eerily lonely. My hair was cut by my mom, and it was unflattering, to say the least. And then I got an allergic reaction to something while moving in, and I spent the first night crying myself to sleep. True story. I thought everyone was gonna give me COVID, or I thought that even worse, I would get it and pass it to everyone without even realizing it. I was such a paranoid person. I found everything possible to worry about, carried so much unnecessary weight on my shoulders that I didn't know how to shake off. That's just the type of person I was, always stressing about something. I had an inkling of what I wanted this semester to be like, but no more than that. What it really felt like was starting over in a cold and, for the most part, unfamiliar place. I could feel the transition begin from teenager into adulthood, from angsty yet somehow lighthearted to stressed and slightly afraid. Starting a new life in the city with two suitcases and a camera. It's snowing outside today. Well, it's actually not snowing right now. It stopped snow. It stopped snowing. Classes are gonna start in a couple of days. When it started snowing, New York felt like a movie. One where everyone's happy and throwing snowballs at each other and laughing, and those pretty lights are on, and families are baking cookies and making warm drinks, and things are good. 'Cause look at nature doing its magnificent thing, and boom, everyone temporarily forgets about their worries. It was nice while it lasted, and kind of scary even. Then for a while, things settled down and it just got kind of dreary, honestly. It was still bitterly cold and the city was just empty brown trees and cold concrete. School was starting to get monotonous at this point. I started to sleep in through my classes and lose the motivation I had at the start of the year. And every time I had a slip up, the worry and the pressure would start to build, only to begin this cycle of draining, trying and failing, trying and failing, trying and succeeding. Life was at times, or maybe more than at times, monotonous. Here I was paying a hefty fee to live in the so-called greatest city in the world, just to struggle and struggle until midnight when my head finally hit the pillow and I could get some peace and quiet from my mind. That is, until the highlight of my life at this point was getting iced coffee, which I got a little too much and kind of burned a hole in my wallet, which then stressed me out, but I had other things preoccupying me. Then, as the weather started to see occasional warm days, I started to slowly come alive again. I started to reconnect with some old friends and do fun things and dress up nice. And finally, I got over my germ paranoia and went back to the library. And you should know, Bob's Library is one of my favorite places. The other highlight of my life was going to the dog park and watching these carefree little dogs sprint around without a single care in the world. And then it got stressful. As the days got warmer, things started to get busy again. Spring meant summer was next, and that meant internship deadlines, summer plans, junior year classes, midterms, round two, and even worse, finals. When the vaccine came out, it felt like a miracle breakthrough. The seasons reflected the city's spirit, coming alive again after a harsh and long winter. The city once again turned white, except this time with spring blossoms and not snow. People would gather in groups again. The word vaccine, Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson were heard far and wide and tossed back and forth across the streets in conversation. Then came the final race to the finish line, the last hurdles of the year. By the time I finished all my finals, the city was green again. It felt like such a blessing. The week after finals was over, life truly felt like a gift. Then all of a sudden, here we were, all saying our goodbyes and see you in the fall and asking about each other's plans for the summer. These last few warm weeks in New York, they were a hard-earned reward. So, did the story sound familiar to you? Maybe it's just like your story, where an imperfect person meets an imperfect place. And then where life sometimes sucks when it shouldn't. And then is the greatest gift when you're least paying attention. And every single day is more or less the same until one day you realize just how much you've actually changed. That's just life.